Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today we are going to learn the CMOS trigger circuit using the transistor. So in CMOS trigger circuit we are going to give the input as a sine wave, and in output we are going to observe the CMOS trigger circuit output, that is a square waveform. And in this experiment we are going to vary the square waveform width using the amplitude of the input sine wave and also the resistance which we are connecting the experiment. So to understand about this experiment, we have a training kit which is named as CMOS trigger circuit, and the order code for this training kit is 36143. So this is the CMOS trigger circuit diagram on the front panel using the PNP transistor. So for this CMOS trigger circuit operations we need a decayed audio frequency generator. So here we are having a decayed audio frequency generator. We also need a power supply from 0 to 12 volt. We also need a CRO. So here we have a CRO, and we also need a decayed resistance box. So here we are having a decayed resistance box. So this is the CRO, this is the function generator or audio frequency generator, and this is the decayed resistance box and three patch codes. So now I am going to perform the experiment as shown in the procedure of our Tesca's manual. So trace the circuit according to the diagram given in the figure 3. So make the circuit in the training board as is shown in this figure. So connect the ...12 volt supply here to here, now connect the input of function generator, that is a sine wave of 1 kilohertz, to the input terminals of training board. So here I am connecting the input of frequency generator or audio generator to the input of training board, and the output of training board to the CRO. So now read the procedure. I am reading the procedure shown in the written in the manual. Connect the power supply to the terminal negative and positive to the terminal. Connect the audio oscillator to the terminals input as shown in the panel. Now connect the decayed resistance box across the terminal A and B. So here I am connecting the decayed resistance box on terminals A and on the terminal B. Now using this decayed resistance box we have to make the resistance equal to R2 resistance, means we have to give this resistance value 3k9. So to make it 3k9, make the decayed resistance box at 3k. So here 1k, 2k and 3k, and 3k9 means 3900 ohm. So here by using the decayed resistance box I have made the AB terminal resistance at 3k9. Now fix the value of resistance in the decayed resistance box at approximately 3k9, and also the audio oscillator frequency at 1 kilohertz. So here I have given the frequency of sine wave input at 1 kilohertz. Here I am giving the input frequency of 1 kilohertz. Now starting from a low value, go on increasing the amplitude of the audio signal and see that at lower amplitude there is a no waveform seen on the screen of the oscilloscope, and when the amplitude of the audio signal reaches a particular value, the desired square waveform will appear on the oscilloscope. So now we are going to increasing the amplitude of sine wave. Here you can see the amplitude of sine wave is 0. So now to perform this experiment, first of all turn on the training board. So now I have given the 230 volt AC main supply to the training board. Now turn on the training kit. Press the auto mode of CRO. So here no waveform, nothing is showing on the CRO display. So now as I increasing the amplitude of sine wave using the function generator, so you can see at peak to peak of 5 volt we are getting the square waveform. Again I am increasing the peak to peak voltage using the function generator, and in the CRO we are getting the square waveform. So now when we get the desired waveform, that is a square waveform, we have to stop at that position. So here we are getting a square waveform in the output. So I have told you the output of schematic trigger circuit is a square waveform. So we are getting the desired value of the square waveform. Now keeping the audio output fixed means now fix the all the parameters of function generator at the same position. Now change the supply voltage and note the change in amplitude of the square waveform. So now using the supply voltage, I am going to vary the supply voltage and we are going to see the changes in the amplitude of the square waveform which are showing in the oscilloscope. So here I am changing the so you are going to see this that the so in the output when I vary the amplitude we are getting the change in the amplitude of square waveform. So when I vary the IC regulated power supply we are getting the different amplitude square waveform. Now keeping the supply fixed at the value indicated, now change the value of resistance in the decade box and see the effect on the waveform and note the change in amplitude of the square wave without any other appreciable change in the waveform. So now we are going to fix all the parameter which I have fixed earlier. Now we are going to vary the resistance using the decade resistance box and we are going to observe the output on the CRO. So here I am changing the decade resistance box. So you can see there is a changes in the square waveform. So on different resistance value you can observe the changes in the square waveform. Now keeping other parameter fixed, now fix all the parameter which I have changed earlier and at suitable values change the frequency of the audio signal and note the change in the waveform. So from the function generator now I am going to change the frequency. So here I'm starting to change the frequency using the function generator, and you can observe the output waveform in the CRO. So here I am continuously increasing the frequency using the function generator, and you can see the square waveform is getting compressed. So these are the changes we can make using the frequencies, decay resistance box, and the IC regulated power supply. So this is all about the Schmidt trigger circuit. So you can perform same experiment watching this video, and also you can go with our manual. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.